What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com and today's PL SQL tutorial is about blocks in PL SQL programs. So without further ado, let's get started with the quick intro of PL SQL language. PL SQL stands for Procedural Language / Standard Query Language. It's a significant member of Oracle programming toolset which is extensively used to code server-side programming. Similar to SQL language, PL SQL is also a case insensitive programming language. Generally, a program written in PL SQL language is divided into blocks. We can say blocks are basic programming units in PL SQL programming language. There are two types of blocks in PL SQL: anonymous block and named block. Both type of PL SQL blocks are further divided into three different sections, which are the declaration section, the execution section, and the exception handling section. The execution section is the only mandatory section of blocks, whereas declaration and exception handling sections are optional. And here is the basic prototype of anonymous PL SQL block. Let's quickly discuss each of these sections in brief. You can visit my blog for detailed explanation and examples. The link is in the description box below. Declaration section. This is the first section of PL SQL block, which contains definition of PL SQL identifiers such as variables, constants, cursors, and so on. You can say this is the place where all local variables used in the program are defined and documented. Also, declaration section always start with keyword declare. Next is execution section. This section contains executable statements that allow you to manipulate the variables that have been declared in the declaration section. The execution section of any PL SQL blocks always begins with keyword begin and ends with the keyword end. This is the only mandatory section in PL SQL block. This section supports all DML commands and SQL plus built-in functions. It also supports DDL commands using native dynamic SQL or DBMS underscore SQL built-in package. And the next section is exception handling section. This is the last section of PL SQL block, which is optional just like the declaration section. This section contains statements that are executed when a runtime error occurs within the block. We can see all exception handling codes goes here. You can visit my blog where I have explained this tutorial in more detail, covering all the parts which will help you face interview questions or Oracle certification exam. Link is in the description box. With this, I will wind up today's tutorial. Please like this video, also share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. You can also follow me on my Twitter and Instagram. The links are on your screen. We'll see you soon with another tutorial. Till then, take care. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.